Hi guys, I'm Zach from Nerdworks Media, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to install your Nerdworks Miata headlight kit. I don't really have an official name really for them. Anyway, disclaimer, the brackets that for the headlights that you're seeing in this video are not the official thing. These are still the demo ones that I've been running on my car, and they still were experimental and not cut 100% and everything. The ones you guys will be getting are finalized. Just the ones that I'm going to be doing the install video on are not the official thing. So just disclaimer, be warned and such. They are subject to change. All right, well, first up, I'm sure you all know what my headlight kit looks like. In case you haven't, I'm gonna have a link in the description down below to the demo video that I made showcasing all their features and such. Alright, secondly, we gotta run through all the tools you're gonna need for this job. So you're gonna need a ruler, a ratchet, an extension arm for that ratchet, a 10mm socket. I recommend, though, you take an assortment of sockets in case you need extra help for, I don't know, one of the other bolts. You're gonna need two 10mm spanners, one 12mm spanner, one 13mm spanner, one 14mm spanner, a star screwdriver, a size 4mm and a size 3mm Allen keys. I'd recommend taking a marker just so you can name and label things, but you don't need to. A long nose pliers and possibly side cutters. Thirdly, we've got to talk about the wiring that I've already done for my car since, well, I've been running these headlights for a while already. So we have the two yellow wires, one for each light. These are your halos. I've joined them all for both lights later on in the cable into one red wire. This goes to an ignition live point. It doesn't really matter where as long as it's on ignition live. So this means that when you turn on your car, you get power to the halos. Next, we have the indicators. For these, simply find the plug at the bottom of your light where your indicator plug is, basically the indicator and the little daytime running lights on the side, and find the green wire, or at least it was green for me anyway. And then tap the two white wires onto that. Finally, for the wiring, you'll see you have these two bad boys. Now, there are obviously two cables for both headlights, but they're going to go into the one original headlight plug. Both the black wires go into the right port, then one red into the top port, and the other red one into the left port. These are your driving and bright lights. Which cable you wired into what will determine which one is your bright and which one is your dim. I personally run it so that the cable for the light that is on the inside, so toward the center of my car, that is what I run to be my bright light. So I did the cabling accordingly. All right, finally you caught up, so let's get installing. First, we're going to take the pop-up motor for the headlights out, and we are going to change the, and we are going to swap the arms. When you remove the previous arm, I recommend that you put a little line or something on it so you can see the exact position that the, or exact angle that the arm was at, so that when you put the new arm on, you can put it in the exact same position and the exact same angle. Then with the longer push arm for the headlights, you're going to need to adjust that to the correct length. Unfortunately, this is a trial and error situation because it has to do with, well, we made it adjustable so that you can adjust to the correct height that it pops up or comes back down, as well as if you need it to fit against the fender and bumper or hood better. There's too many variables, so we just made it adjustable so you guys can suit it exactly to how you need it. For reference sake, my arm is adjusted to 8.3cm. Now that the motor is sorted out, we can put it all back together. So as of right now, I'm not sure if I'm selling the kit pre-assembled or if I'm selling it in parts that to be assembled. If I am selling it pre-assembled, then you can skip to the timestamp on screen now. If I'm not, well then just keep watching. Next up, we have to install the lights to the headlight frame. You'll see that I've labeled mine with a top and a bottom, or which side is top. This is because you'll see there is an adjustment for the light, so you can set how tall the beam is or whatever. For your bright lights, you need that on top. For your dims, you need that on the bottom. Otherwise, you'll be driving around blinding people. Again, depending on if you're having them on the inside or the outside, make sure they're in the correct position and then make sure obviously they're getting the right cable. Finally, just tighten them in with the nuts and bolts that should be provided. And yeah, there you go. All right, now that the lights are inside the frame, let's put the frame inside the car. So to do this, we are going to just quickly attach the push arm to the bottom of the frame. Now, before we attach it to the original headlight bracket inside the car, as a forewarning, if you will, depending if your car's been in an accident or how your fenders are adjusted, you may need to hammer the or knock in slightly the lip of the fender. I unfortunately had to just knock it in slightly to get the, otherwise they'll end up scratching the headlights as they come up and down. Once that's done, you can actually attach the headlight frame to the rest of the bracket. To do this, you can use the small spacer on the inside and then the larger one on the outside. And we're gonna tighten these, but don't tighten them exceptionally tight, remembering that these are swivel points. They need to slide slightly. So they need to be tight so the headlight bracket obviously doesn't shake loose, but not so tight that they actually can't pivot. All right, almost finished now. So just to neaten things up, we're going to tape up all the wiring now and just make sure that it's sealed from all the elements and not gonna pop out of it. Then finally, last but not least, we need to get the headlight covers back on. So to do this, you're gonna need, you're gonna place your little clips on the brackets here, here, and here. And then finally take your Allen key bolt with its nut and washer and place it here. Now, again, unfortunately, you're gonna have to slide and position them as you need. And then adjust your headlight bracket as you need. Unfortunately, even with the stock headlights, all us Miata guys know those headlight plates are ridiculously like complicated to get to adjust the fit perfectly towards your fender and bumper and hood. So I've made them adjustable so you guys can adjust them. So go about adjusting them basically. And there we go. You should officially have your Nerdworks headlights fitted and on. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed today's episode. And until next time, guys, cheers.